Good morning. I am Kevin Price. Delighted to be with you. Got to spend some time talking to you about you and your business. We have a lot to cover on today's program, and I'm going to get right straight to it. I got Dr. L. Moody on the program, and he's going to talk about the recovery book. And, you know, it's kind of a big title. And the reason why is because it's a big book, and I recently got a copy of it. I've been checking it out. I'm a big fan of recovery. I've seen so many people's lives, you know, and people, including in my own own universe, if you will, that have been adversely affected by some horrible things, and have seen the difference that recovery can make in their lives. And so, you know, and I know people in the business community, people who listen to programs like The Price of Business, struggle with a lot of these challenges. And so I'm glad to be able to talk about it here on today's program. Welcome, Dr. Moody.
Great to talk with you, Kevin. I appreciate your interest in such an important and timely topic.
Yeah, no question about it. Kind of give us a little bit of your background before we get started.
Kevin, I got interested in the addiction field as a kid. It wasn't professional interest, but addiction runs in my family. And as a child, my dad was a prominent physician, but ended up spiraling down in his addiction and finally went to prison. My mom ended up in some mental institutions. And at 10 years old, I began to have a lot of questions about where my life and my family's life was going. Of course, it was very, very fortunate that through that ugly process, they found recovery. And we have now had four generations of recovery in my family. And as I got into my professional education, I was pretty horrified that the medical profession is really not adequately addressing our country's number one health problem. So that became my specialty, and I had the opportunity to work at the hospital that came out of my mom and dad's recovery called Willingway in Statesboro, Georgia. And out of that, I had an opportunity to write this book to share what had been so wonderful in my life with others that may be confused about a lot of the misinformation and controversy about recovery out there.
Right. So how old were you when your parents, you know, one went into a prison, the other went into a mental institution? What ages were you, respectively?
When they got sober, I was 11 years old.
And okay, so they were like, you were, an infant when they started to leave, when one left, or?
Well, when my dad was pulled out of the family, and of course they were both gone at odd times. We were picked up by relatives and friends and neighbors who took care of us, and it was a very confusing time. But then when my dad came back, and very openly and honestly, I know now he was working some steps in his recovery program, but he said, look, I've been in prison. I have a deadly disease, and some people have told me that if I do certain things, you know, we don't have to spiral down anymore and don't have to die. So
yeah.
I was all ears, and it cut through all the ignorance, shame, and guilt. And I was so lucky to be at a young age like that that I didn't carry a lot of the stigma that most people do when they learn about it older.
Yeah, in a way, you hit your bottom before adolescence, your own bottom, huh? Not one that you created, but that your family created for you. And so you know that became a new way of living rather early.
And it excited me because in AA, they talk about the psychic change. And I actually watched that happen. The dad that I had never known came back into my life. And, boy, that you know, that really piqued my interest. And now there's exciting new brain science that we've actually interpreted for people in early and late recovery. There's exciting new brain science now that shares, yes, the brain does heal. It's just like they said in AA, your brain can recover. But this is all new stuff that supports what I've seen in evidence in my family for over 50 years.
Yeah. They talk about the plasticity of the brain. You know, the brain can change.
Neuroplasticity. When the brain is damaged with alcohol, it doesn't work as well. But the thing that is now just being uncovered in science is there's an opposite of that called positive neuroplasticity. When we challenge and exercise the brain, just like we grow from exercising at the gym, there's a way to take your brain to the gym to build neural pathways and brain cells to promote good recovery and happiness throughout life and pass it on to other generations.
Right. Which is, by the way, for the listener, that would include going to the literal gym as part of changing the brain as well, as it builds our self-esteem, taking care of ourselves. But also bringing blood where blood's supposed to go in parts of our body for healing. So I would tell you that that's a huge part of the healing process.
Right. Exercise is very important. Now, what we do also understand is that early in recovery, if a person goes to the gym and isolates them in a little cocoon emotionally of all the Nautilus equipment, they're probably not going to grow emotionally. So we have developed a zone system where early in recovery, we encourage even things like nutrition and exercise that promote fellowship and working the steps and detox and those things. Whereas later in recovery, after you've been through the red and the yellow and now you're in the green zone, going to the gym may very and setting goals for your exercise may actually be the best thing you could do for your health.
Yeah, absolutely. Because let's face it, isolation is a big part of what kept people in that disease.
Right, and it gets confusing.
And so getting together with people is part of that healing process.
I know my health's bad, and then they go to the gym and isolate or start eating right, and there's no time to save their life with recovery tools using the steps. And so the zone approach. And if I made a contribution to the addiction field, it is this growth method of recovery, red, yellow, green, activate your recovery, build the life you've dreamed of, and then celebrate by living as long as you can and passing it on to others, red, yellow, green. And that seems to fit the process that has been going on now for over half a century in the recovering community.
So, Who did you have in mind when you wrote the book?
When we wrote the book originally, it was to help the people who were leaving treatment get the information to carry with them so they could avoid relapse and grow in recovery. So, and maybe it's not a surprise, but I didn't anticipate it. Families and friends of people in recovery are the ones that seem to jump on the book the hardest. I've had more questions from family members and friends since the book came out yesterday than I've had from people looking for their own recovery. So we designed the book to maintain the same but updated content, you know, with technology and our recovery zone system. But we now have a special section at the end for families so that they can go back and reference the content in their own chapter that would guide them through helping someone or growing out of some of the codependent sickness that families develop in lifelong recovery.
Yeah. Yeah, that's interesting. You know, it is a family disease, and so many of these people got to the point of hitting their bottom because of codependency. They were surrounded by people who mitigated their circumstances and created a buffer that just made it easier for them to stay in their disease. So it really needs to be dealt with by the family.
Right. When we grow up in addiction all around us, you know, we're imprinted on sickness being the only thing we know. So that actually defaults to kind of a health attitude. And families have to learn, if they're going to heal, they have to learn that a lot of what we think of as normal is really sick, even though we're not the ones that are drinking and doing the drugs.
Yeah, no question about it. So people need to find a better way. This book, which is very substantial, but written in a style that is a great beginning tool, but also a great reference tool for those who are more familiar with recovery. It has a lot of value. I encourage people to learn more about it. Dr. Moody, thanks so much for being with us. By the way, what are your credentials in? I was just curious.
I'm sure I'm a medical doctor. Well, I started out in family medicine, so we have a lot of medical information in the recovery book, a lot of science now, a lot of exciting new brain science. People can find the book really any bookstore or online, or go to therecoverybook.com and order it through our webpage and get a lot of bonus information. Believe it or not, we had more than 600 pages, and we had to take a little out, but you can find that on our website.
Thanks for being with us. When we come back, much more for you. Do want to remind you, best content here does show up over there at usdailyreview.com. While there, like it on Facebook, follow it on Twitter.